Dude, Ford surprised everybody, I think, with their demo of an all-electric prototype towing over 1 million pounds, and I think it's pointing the way to the future.
No, you're wrong, my friend.
What?
No, it's not the future, it's a gimmick. But I will say this, Ford was smart by doing this to fend off the bad guys, so to speak. You know, Tesla and the guys coming in from Bollinger, and Chevrolet for that
matter. And Rivian.
And Rivian, who they're partnered with. The point is that I think that these electric trucks are kind of like toys, you know what I mean? They're kind of like a fun little thing on the side. I don't think they're real.
I beg to differ, but first, let's just go over what they did.
Okay.
So they were in a rail yard with 10 double-decker rail cars that carry cars and trucks for delivery, and they hooked 10 of them together, and according to them, empty cars together were about 1 million pounds. And then they unveiled this truck that looks identical to the current F-150 2019.
Right.
Right? It has the same grille, same body, but there's a couple unique elements to it.
That's right. Tell them.
Which we can go over. Slightly different grille, no fog lights, and underneath you can kind of see the sidestep hiding something that looks like a battery pack, perhaps.
Possibly.
And also that what looks like independent rear suspension.
Right. Now, this could highlight the fact that they are in a bit of a partnership with Rivian, right?
Yeah.
And Rivian's platform is what they would call a skateboard platform, where it's a flat pack with batteries, and then you have a suspension on the outside, but you don't really have a proper transaxle, so to speak, or anything like that, right?
Right, or a drive shaft or anything of that sort. And then they pulled the empty cars about 1,000 feet, and and then they loaded the cars with 42 F-150s, regular ones,
right?
And then they pulled it again. So that, according to them, was about 1,250,000 pounds.
I have something to say.
Yes.
Space shuttle.
Are you referring to Toyota Tundra pulling a space shuttle?
I am indeed.
Well, that weighed about 300,000 pounds.
Yes, actually over 300,000 pounds. And that was done with a conventional regular pickup truck, once again on a flat surface. And it was a publicity stunt. Look, the thing is that once you start pulling an object, you have physics work in your favor if it's a flat piece of terrain. Am I correct?
Yes, I absolutely agree with you.
I could push a 5,000-pound vehicle. Roman could push a 4,000-pound vehicle.
Well, I think you and I, well, I don't think we can move one of these rail cars.
No, not even close.
But you and I can pull a truck, a heavy-duty truck, along a flat piece of ground.
We've done it before.
Yes.
We've done something like that before. And my point here is, it is impressive to pull a lot of weight, of course, and there's a lot of torque that electric motors have. However, if they pulled it uphill, then I'd be like, oh my God, right?
Yes. I would be impressed if they could stop 1 million pounds going down Ike Gauntlet.
Stop.
But let's just look at the specs, okay? So in April, Ford and Rivian announced a partnership.
Uh-huh.
Ford invested about $500 million, $500 million, into Rivian, and they said they're going to share platform components, which could potentially be this Ford F-150, although the Rivian truck wheelbase is a little bit shorter than this F-150s, so you have to modify it.
That's true, and let's not forget, they also have a partnership, Ford, with Volkswagen, who also has electric technology that's way out there.
Yes, so that's according to Ford, and Ford is currently the leader in trucks. And they have other companies like Tesla, like you mentioned, like Bollinger, maybe Atlas.
Yeah, well, we'll get to those in a sec.
Yeah, challenging them, right? Saying, you know, we have some products that will challenge you. And Ford doesn't want to be on the back foot, right? So I think this is the future because you mentioned off-roading, right?
Right.
So the Rivian truck, there was it has air suspension, adjustable height. You can go over like 12 inches of ground clearance.
Awesome.
A lot of articulation. You can put beefy tires on it. And with their 180 kilowatt hour battery pack, which is insanely big and insanely heavy, you can go up to 400 miles.
400 miles, is that off-road?
No, it's like highway driving.
Now, let me ask you a question here, and this is going back to that, and I'm going to keep going back to it because I'm not going to let you off because you're wrong.
Mm.
Here's the thing. When you're going off-road, fuel consumption drops through the toilet, no matter what. And if you're doing serious rock crawling, it's really bad. Why? Because you're using a lot of torque, a lot of energy in order to get over obstacles.
Yes.
Now, your 400-mile range will dwindle remarkably fast.
Well, let's say half.
Well, we could say even
quarter.
Less. Okay.
100 miles. When was the last time you drove 100 miles off-road just for the day?
Last week.
What? Where were you?
I went fishing.
Okay.
Yeah, the best part was it was in my wife's car, which used to be my Nissan. And I only had like a quarter of a tank, like when I got to where I was going, yeah. And I was like, oh boy. So I had to feather it and carefully, fortunately, I was coming downhill on the downhill portion, bouncing around. Yeah. And I was on fumes. And that got me thinking about that.
Yes.
Now, I was able to get to a gas station really quick, fuel up, and be out of there in 10 minutes. You can't do that with an electric vehicle currently. We know that. What would Mr. Truck say if he was towing a trailer? And you know and I know that towing a trailer takes that battery power and drops it, once again, through the toilet.
Significantly, of course.
So what you going to do when you're towing 10,000 pounds and you're going up a grade, like Ike Gauntlet?
Well, I spoke to Mr. Truck about this, and he's open-minded about electric trucks. Yes, he's open-minded, which shocked me. Yes, and you and I did many MPG loops in gas-powered trucks, in diesel trucks, right? And you're absolutely right. You half or even more, you know, your actual range and your fuel economy drops by at least half.
Yeah.
So it would be the same, if not worse, with electricity.
Yeah, it's a big problem.
I give you that, of course. But like Tesla has built out an entire network of superchargers.
They have an impressive network.
Yes, and their software tells you, you know, when you say I'm going to go to this supercharger, it'll tell you whether you can make it or not in advance. So
you're driving a dry vehicle without towing a load up a grade or anything like that.
We but they also have like the Model X has a towing mode.
It does.
Yeah. So I mean, it looks like Elon Musk is already thinking about these things and the Tesla team. And like you said it yourself, torque.
Yes.
You have a lot of it.
I agree.
You can pull stumps with it. Mr. Truck would be probably happy with that. You could tow. Yes, not long distance, but you can tow. And Tesla is also working in a semi-truck that's electric.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
Yes.
And you're right about that, of course. What about those people who have, I don't know, farms and large swaths of property, big swaths of property? What are you going to do? Are you going to get a solar array and hook it up to the back of your trailer, to the back of the other trailer?
Yes.
And then tow it with and open it up and just say, you know what, we're just going to take a long lunch here and hang out for the next 6 hours while we get one or two bars of electricity in our vehicle so we can hopefully get off our farm.
Well, actually, this is the concept behind Bollinger. Robert Bollinger has a big ranch or farm, big property.
Right.
And he wanted to go out and build a fence.
Okay.
Okay, so he needs to bring a generator or some tools out there to build it.
Right.
Right. So his Bollinger electric truck can act as a mobile generator. He can charge it in his main house, drive it, I don't know, a mile or two on his property, and actually build something with power tools, and then come home.
What if he uses all the electricity when he's out where he's going? I mean,
well,
what I'm trying to say is that it's exactly, it's not quite to the point to where we have that massive range. They have to find a way to create a vehicle that can tow, can pull, can go off-road, and still maintains a decent range. And I think that that's the part where we're still in shaky terrain. Yes, you can pull 1 million pounds going flat. You can tow 350,000 pounds a shuttle with a gas truck on a flat surface. You can tow whatever you want, a big giant boat from GMC, right?
Sure, yeah.
Flat terrain,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yes, those are all cool things to see on video, but that's not indicative. That's not indicative of what that vehicle can do in regular driving environments.
But I was surprised. I was really surprised by what Ford did because, you know, we've seen the prototypes running around.
Right.
We have pictures and a little bit of video.
Yeah, we know for a fact they're driving around.
Yeah. But they just said, you know, forget about those prototype spy shots. We're going to give you an official look at this early. They didn't say when it's coming, but they did say that next year in 2020 calendar year, their F-150 hybrid, which is still promising, will be on sale.
Now, that could be an interesting truck to me because it kind of combines both worlds. So we'll see what that can do. I don't want to completely put down. I like electric vehicles. I like the idea of them, and I'm beginning to see them as a much more logical alternative to certain other vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
My issue is the trucks and what a truck is capable and supposed to do. I just don't think they're there yet with the capability. I haven't seen anybody show me a vehicle that can do what a regular gas vehicle can do as efficiently without having to have a generator, you know, in the back of somebody else's truck.
Well, we'll be doing a lot more testing on this. We're going to see Bollinger team soon, so we're going to speak to them.
That'll be cool.
Rivian, we already interviewed them a couple of times.
Right, but they've been really nice, by the way.
Yeah, and they're coming with more vehicles in about 6 months, right. some more working prototypes. So we'll be doing a lot more testing. So we'll actually give you everybody a chance to study this in the real world, which is going to be really cool. And of course, the hybrid F-150 is going to be also interesting. And guys, let us know, like, for your daily work or daily life, would the electric truck make sense? Let us know in the comments below what your usages are and how that works.
Prove Andre wrong.
And prove Nathan wrong, too.
See you guys.